Switching gears now, Palawan has been hailed as the most desirable island in the world. UK-based travel magazine Wanderlust describes the scenery and the famed tourist destination as heaven on earth, with sparkling waters and white sand beaches. It also said its readers particularly love the Kayangad Lake, which features spectacular rock formations. Aside from Palawan, the islands of Tobago and Viti Levu were also recognized by the magazine. For the Philippine Tourism Department, the recognition reflects the agency's efforts to revive the local tourism industry. Very tough. That's how Labor Secretary Bienvenido Laguesma described the task of balancing employer and employee interests when it comes to wage hike petitions. Laguesma earlier ordered regional wage boards to review whether another round of salary increase is needed to cushion the impact of rising prices of goods. But he notes, wage adjustments can only be implemented once a year, and any hikes, if approved, will be effective next year. The latest minimum wage hikes were implemented in June this year. For now, Laguesma says the focus should be on upskilling workers.
We'd like to see in the very near future, hopefully, that we will have more full-time work, more secure jobs. No, again, not simply temporary one. We are concerned on two things: the underemployment, which continues to be at number that is of serious concern to us. Secondly, on the quality of jobs, because we see. Because we see that most of those employment opportunities or employment being available by our workers belong to the so-called lower skill and lower paying categories.
As for the Trade Union Congress of the Philippines, it says government needs to address inflation first before mulling another round of wage hikes.
Dito sa aming research na kung hindi natin i-address yung mga basic roots ng inflation na sa tingin namin sa TUCP ay food inflation na ngayon ay nasa 9.8% sa Oktobre at yung electricity inflation na nasa 22%, any wage increase might actually be inflationary. Magkaroon tayo ng pagtutulungan sa sober assessment kung ano yung ways forward. Kasi at the end of the day, it's not just about government doing something, it's about government doing things right.
Lawmakers also urged to pass the Magna Carta for informal workers to address underemployment. Rene Ofreneo, the former dean of the UP School of Labor and Industrial Relations, says informal workers make up majority of the country's labor force, and yet they remain vulnerable to abusive work conditions.
Pag sinabi pong informal, edi siyempre hindi nag-a-apply ang mga batas ng Kodigo ng Paggawa, Labor Code. Pag may crisis sa ekonomi at mahirap maghanap ng quality jobs na kung tawagin ng ILO ay decent jobs, kinakailangan ang nangyayari just to survive, people try to, well, pasok ng pasok kahit na low quality jobs, kahit na underpaid, kahit na hindi protected.